So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Port Clares and our parish team and myself, you're very welcome to St. Clare's today. Welcome those joining us on our webcam. You're very welcome. You join us in prayer and in spirit. Welcome those who have come to Mass today to remember and to pray for loved ones at this Mass. Welcome back to our children's choir today. The gallery is full of our little children singing out good and loud. Welcome back, guys, and our musicians who has with them as well, and Katrina who's leading them today. And also a special welcome to the boys and girls from second class in Skull Cove and or to St. Feix National School and their teachers and their parents and families, because this is their first Mass of their parish preparation programme. These children are the special people in our parish this year because they're hearing the invitation of Jesus in the Gospel today, come to me. The invitation of let the children come to me so that he can bless them. They have come today so we can bless them and ask God to be with them as they prepare really well for First Penance and First Holy Communion. Also welcome our Sunday school children. So anyone who is in second class, I want you to stay out today. But the rest who are younger, you can go on in now with our Sunday school leaders and learn all about a very, very special man that you're going to learn about today. So any small ones, come on in now. Loads of new teenagers helping along with Kira and Jenny, our adult leaders. Well done, guys. A few more coming from the side wings. I know some of them are up in the choir as well, so they can't come in either today, but they will be in back with us again next week in Sunday school. Okay, thanks, guys. We'll talk to you later. So we have come to Mass to support one another in prayer. We have come to listen to Jesus, to allow him to nourish us with the readings, but also to nourish us with the Eucharist. Let's pray that we will be worthy for this celebration by just calling to mind our sins. The fact that we are human, we do make mistakes. Let's pause for a few moments now in silence. So boys and girls, if you have your special booklets with you, we're going to open page 5. This is a prayer that you're going to begin to learn soon in school and with your parents. Or you can check out the screens either because they're on both. So let's all pray together with the children. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. If you turn the page now, we're going to say the great hymn of praise. This is a hard one, but you'll be learning it during the year. So let's all pray, or from our screens, the great hymn of praise. So we pray, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone art the Holy One, you alone art the Lord, you alone art the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. So we pray, so this prayer is on the screens, so let's all join and pray together. Loving God, open our minds and hearts today to your word. May we always be inspired to live out your values of peace, hope, and love each day. We make this prayer to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now. We're going to listen to God's word.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said, "Let the water be filled with living things, and let birds fly in the air above the earth." So, God created the large sea animals, and he also made every bird that flies. And God saw that this was good. God blessed them and said, "Fill the water of the sea, and let the birds grow in number on the earth." Then God said, "Let the earth be filled with animals. Let there be tame animals, the small crawling animals, and wild animals." So God made the wild animals, the tame animals, and all the small crawling animals. And God saw that this was good. The word of the Lord. The response to the psalm is, "May the Lord bless us all the days of our life." The Lord will bless you if you respect him and obey his laws. Your fields will produce, and you will be happy, and all will go well. Response: "May the Lord bless us all the days of our life." Your life will be as fruitful as a grapevine, and just as an olive tree is rich with olives. Your home will be rich with healthy children. Response: "May the Lord bless us all and the days of our life." That is how the Lord will bless everyone who respects him. I pray that the Lord will bless you from Zion, and let Jerusalem prosper as long as you live. Response: "May the Lord bless us all the day of our life."
Thanks, Rannick. So before we stand for the gospel acclamation, I'm going to invite up the children preparing for First Penance and First Communion to come on up here, and their parents will just guide them. Come on up here, stand in the front. Bring your green form with you as well, because that's the form that we need to bless at this Mass. So when the children are coming up, let's all stand and join the choir now in greeting the gospel. Come on up, stand across. So now, boys and girls, are you ready to listen? Good, because sometimes I might ask questions, so you have to listen very carefully. Are you ready? The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Remember what I told you to do during the week? We put a little cross on our forehead, because we want to think about God's word, isn't that right? Then we put a little cross on our lips, because we want to speak God's word. And we put a little cross on our hearts because we want to love God's word and live God's word as well. You have come down from the gallery, the ones up there from the choir, good. So listen carefully. We'll do it again. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. People were bringing little children to him for him to lay his hands on them. Jesus' followers turned them away, but when Jesus saw this, he was angry, and he said, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. I tell you truthfully, anyone who does not welcome the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it." Then Jesus put his arms around the children and gave them his blessing. This is the gospel of the Lord. So invite the rest of you to be seated. Boys and girls, you stand there with your little sheet for me. Now, this is a great start. I'm very impressed to see so many of you coming to church today to begin your parish preparation for First Penance and First Holy Communion. Well done, and thank you. And thank you, mammies and daddies and families, for bringing them to church today as well. Lovely to see you. Will you listen to the first reading about how Jesus, or how God actually, blessed all of the animals and all of the birds and all of the fish. Last Friday, we had a feast of St. Francis. St. Francis always blessed the animals and the birds and the fish. So today, Buddy is inviting all of you who have pets to come to get a blessing. Have all of you got pets? Put up hands how many have got pets. Many have dogs. Many have cats. Many have fish. Many have tigers. Giraffes. Horses. No. Okay. You have a horse. Good. Okay. Are you going to bring the horse for the blessing? Don't let the horse poo-poo, though. Does it destroy the place? Okay. That's great. So bring them at 3 o'clock in front of the Parish Centre today, because St. Francis has treats for your animals and your birds and your fish today as well. Okay. Now, you have begun preparing for First Holy Communion and First Penance. In the Gospel, Jesus today said, "Let the children come to me." In the eyes of Jesus, children are the most special. You are the most special people in our parish this year, because you, yes, because you are preparing for First Penance and First Holy Communion. And we want you during this year to get close to Jesus. We want you to be special friends of Jesus. And we want you to prepare well by doing many things. Did you fill in your form for me? You did. And you go, okay, I'm going to take some of them and just read them out. So I'm going to take yours there and see what you have. Patrick is going to go to Mass on Sunday, and he's going to say his grace at dinner time. That's lovely. If you do that, Patrick, that would be brilliant. Well done. Go across here and get a few more. Well, I look at yours there. It's a small one. Bridgie, you're going to be good for your mammy and daddy. You're going to clean the house. Oh, I'd say mammy and daddy would be happy with that. You're going to go to bed early, and you're going to eat up all your food. Brilliant. Well done. That's lovely things to be doing for your preparing for First Communion. Take one or two more. John is going to do good deeds. He's going to pray more. He's going to be grateful. What a lovely thing that is. And he's going to be nice. Well done. I'm going to take one more here. And Rita is going to go to Mass. You always go to Mass anyway. You know that. You're going to pray. You're going to help others. And you're going to be kind. I'll just go over to... Well done, Rita. We're going to go over here and just take one or two more over here. But I want to look at yours. Don't be hiding them. I want to see them. Okay, you're going to be kind, you're going to help around the house, and you're going to be cheerful to others. Well done, that's lovely. Just the last one then, because we'll be here all day and we want to get ready for the pet's blessing. So, you're going to pray before you go to bed, before eating, and in the morning. You're going to go to Mass when you're allowed to. Oh, I hope your mommy and daddy's allowed you to go to Mass anyway. So, Cahill's mommy, make sure you allow him to go to Mass. And by helping others and by being kind to everyone. Well done. Thanks very much. That's great. So they're lovely, lovely things that you are doing to prepare for First Penance and First Communion. I'm going to bless them now. When I bless them, it means they're holy and sacred. It means you have to make every effort to keep them. Okay? And then you're going to take them home and put them in your holy place. Has anybody got their holy place done yet? You have. Good. I'm delighted. The rest of you, get that holy place done. And put that in, and when, if you invite me to go around to your house for a cup of tea and a big slice of apple tart and cream, I will pray at your sacred space, and I will see all the things we give you, and I will check that form and see how well you're doing. So hold them up. Where's my holy water? Yeah. Hold them up like as if you're at a match and you're waving a flag. Hold them up good and high. All right, wave them. Well done. Okay, now, may Almighty God bless these promises of these special children. May God and Jesus help them to keep these promises so that they will prepare well, so that when First Communion and First Penance comes, they will be truly ready to welcome Jesus and to experience his forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, another thing, because each at our special Masses, even though I do like you to come to Mass every Sunday, I want you to take a gift home with you each week. So this gift today is a gift of the rosary beads, because today is the feast of the Holy Rosary, or this month. You know how rosary is? You do. That's good. But anyway, I hope by the end of the month, or certainly by the end of the year, you will know what the rosary is. When I was your age, we used to always pray the rosary every night. Even if there was a match on the television, or even if there was a big program on, it would be switched off and we would all pray the rosary. The rosary is a prayer to Mary, asking her to help us to get closer to Jesus, which is the main thing. So you'll take one of these home, put it in your sacred space, take it out of the package, don't leave it in the package, and get your mammies and daddies, or if your mammies and daddies don't know the rosary, get your grannies or granddads to help you to pray the rosary. Okay. And even do a little bit of it. You don't have to do the whole lot, because the whole lot takes about 12 minutes. But even if you just do one decade, that's one Our Father, 10 Hail Marys, and a Glory Be to the Father, helping you to get close to Jesus. Okay? So I'm going to ask God to bless these rosary beads now. May Almighty God bless them. There's one fell here. May these children, as they pray to Mary, help Mary to get closer to Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So I've been talking to the boys and girls. Hope I didn't exclude anyone else. I know you've all come, but I do encourage particularly parents to come, not just the special mass, and it's lovely that you're coming, make an effort to come today, but maybe every Sunday here. And the other Sundays, your child can go into Sunday school as well, to give you a chance to maybe help or say your own prayers out here without worrying about them. I'm also encouraging you as well, parents, that maybe your own faith has been slipped in recent times. That's natural. Maybe this is an opportunity now that you're presenting your child for First Communion and First Penance to maybe focus a little bit on your own faith journey as well. I think we all need God and Jesus in our lives. And Jesus made it clear at the Last Supper when he said, "Do this in memory of me." He wants his followers to come to Mass. He asks us, and ever since, people gather on a Sunday morning or a Saturday night to celebrate Mass. So hopefully you will make that effort and make it part of your year as well. Just give you finish you one little quote that Cara gave me. It's from Maya Angelou, and it's up there. "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." Let's make these children feel really good by bringing them to church, helping with their prayers, and celebrating really well their first penance and first communion. Well done. Thanks. So now I'm going to invite the parents' committee, where they come up and take these and just give them out to the children. Here, Mal. There, so split them up between you there. So children, you take one of these from your parents' committee, go back then to your seats, and we will pray along. So when the children are collecting their little rosary beads, put them in the holy place, guys. Keep them there, take them out of the package, and hopefully by the end of the year, you will be able to pray the rosary. So I'm going to invite everyone else to please stand, and I'm going to invite you to pass our blue bags now, which are for church development collection. So if you pass around the bags there, and as the bags are going around, let's all pray the creed, and this is a bit hard for the children, so don't worry about it, but we'll all pray it from this creed. So we pray together. Thank you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. To him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. So now gathered here to prayer, we turn to God and to Jesus with all our needs.
We pray for the children who may be enrolled in our parish sacramental programme this weekend. May they enjoy getting to know Jesus as their special friend. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the church may welcome Christ constantly in the poor, the afflicted, the stranger and the outsider. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
October is dedicated to the promotion of mental health well-being. We pray for an increase in sensitivity toward those who suffer. May their anxieties be relieved and may they have professionals care for them with love and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are sick. Lord, restore their health, soothe their pain and ease their worry. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God of all creation, we think of all those who care for animals, especially animals in need. May they, like Saint Francis of the Assisi, respect the life and value all living creatures on this earth. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Thanks, girls. That's Robin and Titania, who are part of a group of 20 or so young people who began a reader's course yesterday. So lovely to have you, girls. Thank you. As we pray this morning for our faithful departed too, we pray for the reposing souls of Nicholas Lanigan Jr., Calgary, Bridget Shannon, Ratduff, Hollymount, and Leash. We pray for Ernest Breeley, formerly Church Street. We pray for Sadie Burke, Hollywood, County Wicklow, all these who died this past week. We pray this morning for the repose of the souls of Bridie Scully, Slatey. We pray for Leah Kate Hockney, Barravale, the 50th anniversary for Leah Kate, baby Leah Kate today. We pray for Rebecca Lee O'Brien, Newark Estate. We pray for Morris Hayes, Auchmanure, Oak Park. We pray for Margaret Peg Shields, Laura Smore, all these whose anniversaries occur. Lord, grant all our dead eternal rest. Bring comfort to all who mourn. Lord, hear us. Lord, these are our prayers we make to you this day. You are a loving, caring God. We make them now to Christ, who is our Lord and Saviour. Amen. I invite you now to please all be seated. Please pass the red bags for our offertory collection. And four of our children now, Rita, Molly, Cahill and Harley, they're going to bring to the altar now the gifts of bread and wine. So they're ready there, bring them on up. Pray now, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the sacrifices instituted today by your commands, and through this special Mass this morning, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the saving work that you are pleased to bring us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image, set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. So with the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we now acclaim. So boys and girls, this prayer is on page 15, if you want to join it or look at the screen. So we pray together. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Please kneel now, everyone, because we come to the special prayer where we ask God to bless the bread and wine. It becomes the body and blood of Jesus. So, boys and girls, you can follow that in your booklets. It's on page 16 and 17. I just pray the words. It's what happened at the Last Supper, and we're hearing the words that Jesus said. This is my body. This is my blood. Then he said, do this in memory of me. And that's exactly what we're doing today. So you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took the bread, giving thanks. He broke it. He gave it to his friends and he said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his friends, and he said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And then he said, do this in memory of me. So now we proclaim together in song the mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Dennis our Bishop, and all people. Remember our loved ones who we gather to pray for and remember this morning, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Apostles, with St. Clare, St. Felix, St. Francis, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. And so we now pray through him, with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. stand. I'm going to check out and see how's our small ones coming out there. Well done. Have you been working hard? You have? Come on around and let me see what you have done. Show me yours. You have made a little man with a little brown cloak on him. Who's that? Saint Francis. Well done. So that's Saint Francis. And what does Saint Francis do? He looks after all the animals. Exactly. And what's on the sheet? You've drawn a picture as well. You've drawn a picture of St. Francis. Well done. You've got to take that home. You're going to colour it. And St. Francis used to always love the birds. And he loved the dogs and the cats and the fish and the reptiles, everything. So have you got a pet at home? Yes. Yeah? You're to bring your pet today to get it blessed at 3 o'clock. And St. Francis has a little goodie bag for all of the pets as well. So that might be worth doing as well. Okay? So well done, you have learned all about St. Francis and how he looked after all of the animals and the birds. Well done. So let's stand with the children. Hold it up because I think it's worth giving them a clap for that. That's very good. Great work. Wave at them. Thank you, Ciara, leading them today along with Jenny and our 5 teenagers who are doing it for the first time today. Well done and thanks, guys, for that, for volunteering. So let's pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We've been learning out here that little children like you are the special people that Jesus loves the most. So wasn't that lovely to know? Jesus loves you the most. So go back down there. And next week, the second class children, you're welcome to come in and join them. Just stay out for your special masses. So well done all. All back down there. Thanks again, guys. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin, safe from all worries, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. So now the peace of the Lord be with you always. So just for a moment, we pause. I just want to let you to pause because we're celebrating our children today and our young people. And we see the terrible images, particularly this morning from Lebanon where Beirut was bombed. We think of the children in the mosque in Gaza who was also bombed. So many children have died, injured, lost their homes and their schools and their families and have to flee. We think of all the children in Ukraine who have been suffering now for almost 3 years. So we think of them all and we pray. We pray for peace. Pope Francis asks us tomorrow to make a special day to pray for peace. So just for quietly, let's for a moment pray for peace in our world. And so we pray now together. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. This is Jesus. This is his body and his blood. This is Jesus who says, let the little children come to him. This is Jesus who blesses children, who blesses all of us, who nourishes us with the Eucharist, the bread of life. Happy are we to be called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So many, we are one bread, one body. We all partake in the one bread of life. Amen. So just for Holy Communion, just again to familiarize with, because we have our children with us. Those who haven't received communion, parents, make sure they don't receive today. They just cross their arms when they come up, and they will receive a blessing from the priest or the minister. And again, if any parent themselves who maybe feel they don't want to receive, but they would like a blessing, you just cross your arms too, you can receive that blessing as well. So just again, to encourage parents just to come up with your children and guide them in that little act of blessing.
Take the hand of the Lord and walk with him forever. Take the hand of the Lord. Don't let go, whatever. Take
just checking anyone bringing communion to the sick or housebound. O sacrament, most holy, O sacrament, divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of time. Sacred Heart of Jesus, we place all our trust in you. Sacred Heart of Jesus, we place all our trust in you. Sacred Heart of Jesus, we place all our trust in you. And so the love of children. Jesus had a way with children, a welcome for them, a love for them, and saw in them some of the qualities of openness to God. The innocence of children and their weakness touch the strings of love in our hearts. If we are people of love, true followers of Jesus, we will want the best for our children. We want happiness and love for them, good health and a meaning in their lives. We want them to find friends. We want to spare them the hardships of life, and when we cannot, we want to give them a light to guide them in what will be the pain of life. We hope also to give them a way to the inevitable difficulties of love and of growth, which they will find as they make their way to life. Can we give them the way of Jesus? He had a way with children, because he is the way of God. Amen. O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule and guide. Amen. So again, Servers Gabby and Keane, you're going to give out a kids' bulletin there. So if any of the small ones, any one of the small ones can come up now and collect the kids' bulletin. I'm just briefly going to highlight, not going to read everything out, but just highlight. Next Sunday we will have our annual Babies Mass. That's the Mass where we remember all babies who died before, during and after birth. So that's next Sunday at our 11:30 Mass. Big jackpots in our bingo there as well. Outrun Hunger, that's the walk that's coming up to help St. Clair's Hospitality Food Kitchen to make to raise funds. So it's Saturday week, the 19th of October. So maybe families might like to come along and sign up for that, book in, and make that a very, very special day. So that's on as well. Tomorrow we have the relics of St. Bernadette. You know, we have great love for St. Bernadette here in our parish, going to Lourdes every year. And St. Bernadette's relic is in Carlow Cathedral tomorrow, Portlaoise on Tuesday. So every diocese is getting it for the relics for 2 days. So there's a list of the events and celebrations that are on to market coming. Look at there as well. Again, remind you of our pet's blessing today at 3 o'clock. And next Sunday at 6 o'clock, we will have our annual Youth Mass with Bishop Dennis. Because we do this every year, because Bishop Dennis can't get around to all the confirmations. But we feel the confirmation is when the young people get actively involved in their parish. And last March, when our young people made their confirmation, quite a number of them signed up and are now actively involved with us in our youth ministry. So they will receive that special blessing, and also all the young people and children are welcome to come along. Please do have your parents and families to make it a very, very special celebration as well. So loads of other announcements there on as well. So please stand now as we pray our concluding prayer together. So we pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. We make our prayer then to Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your financial support as well. Just remind you that being the first weekend of the month, our monthly St. Vincent de Paul collection is outside as well. And they need our support because they're doing amazing work helping the people on the margins as well. I know you will support them as well. Thanks again to our children's choir. Children, lovely, lovely to have you back. You are super, so well done. And thank you as well. And also to thank Katrina's leading them today and all our young leaders as well. Thank you. Thanks also then our servers here, Gabby and Keane, and Francesca and Lily, a teenager who is learning the slides today, so she's new. Thank you. Our stewards, all our Sunday school teachers and helpers, as I mentioned already, and then our readers, our gift bearers, Eucharistic ministers, and all who minister in any way, and Catherine Sarkston. And a special thanks to Mary and Katrina for organising our children's mass today with our First Communion kids, but also their parents who helped them. Again, to encourage you to try as best you can to make Sunday mass part of your weekly time. We do need God. We do need that space. I know we're busy, but maybe to pencil in the three quarters of an hour every week, it would be lovely. So thank you again. So now the Lord be with you all. And may Almighty God bless us all this day now, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. We go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. So have a good week and stay safe, and God bless you.